Gayton McKenzie uthi, I am going to arrest the corrupt ones. Uthi maqhubeka uthi Gayton McKenzie, I am going to finish in nepotism. Right? Uthi ke, there are people who unduly benefited from government. Uthi ningakhathazeki, bafethu mina ke, I am here. And definitely sure, I'm going to deal with them. And for that, I don't think we should see a problem with that. I mean, come on, guys. He's being honest there and he's being fair there, right? And on another news, the same Minister of Sports, Arts and Culture, Gayton McKenzie, has announced that Gaming Without Borders, gaming now in South Africa. But Kenyan Gaming announces the launch of its product in line with South African market, right? So there's a new game that is basically, it's called Gaming Without Borders. So yeah, man, there's a lot of things that are happening so far as the sporting code is concerned. We are seeing that in sport. So I'm looking at the article of Gayton McKenzie where he's speaking about the fact that yena he's going to arrest people. You know what I'm saying? He's speaking about how he is going to arrest people who are... wait, where is this article now? Guys, I seem to be losing my articles. I don't know where is it disappeared. It just disappeared. It just vanishes now. So, but yeah, he's saying that yena is going to arrest people who are doing this thing called nepotism. Uthi nepotism under Minister Gayton McKenzie uthi it's going to be the thing of the past. Well, so I don't think that should be a problem at all, considering the fact that that is actually a right thing to do. But there's another thing, right thing to do, that is right to do, and it is this.
If you are not yet subscribed, what are you waiting for? Come on, good people. Because to subscribe, it is free. To like the video, it is free. To comment in the comment section below, it is free of charge. To click the notification bell, it is free of charge. To share this video, it is free of charge. To watch this video until the end, it is free of charge. Also, good people, I mean, come on, to watch the ads, it's free of charge, and that's how you financially contribute to this YouTube channel. Speaking about financially contributing to the channel, you can join, become a member of this YouTube channel from as little as 20 rand a month. You can also use the Super Thanks button. In case you don't want to do that, guys, there is a way where you can use my media company banking details to donate to the channel, and you know what I'm saying? Will bring you more, and also guys want to buy more equipment. So the power is in your hands. Please do the honorable thing as we proceed.
Okay, now let's proceed again. Gayton McKenzie, Gayton McKenzie, the heading of the article is quoted by IOLET. I will fire the corrupt Gayton McKenzie, Minister of Arts, Sports and Culture. Ultimate Kubega, literally the article, the new minister has been at it again after unceremoniously shutting down the Super Fans free trip to support SA team on Tuesday. Now, McKenzie has intensified his attention to his own ministry while acknowledging many challenges will be needed under the watch, right? The Patriotic Alliance leader linked old system to that of the mafia in an ex-post. He says, we have majority good people working at Arts, Sports and Culture. We have a corrupt few mafias, but we also have those that got intimidated by those creatives who evoked the names of politicians to demand funding. I will fire the corrupt ones and I will protect the good ones. We will make South Africa proud, says Gayton McKenzie. I mean, honestly speaking, you can't be against the man. Like, literally, you can't be against Gayton McKenzie for doing this. You cannot be against him. We have majority of good people. That's what he says. He says, I will fire the corrupt ones and I will protect the good ones. We will make South Africa proud again. Nepotism was also a major concern within the department, he says in another post. At Sports, Arts and Culture, he says, as a panel of superfans, how is it that it is the same people being is selected always? The same is happening in funding and allocation of tenders. The same beneficiaries everywhere. I can never allow this to continue without clear answers as to why. You know, I understand the issue of tenders. I understand the issue of the issue of tenders, the issue of funding and all the stuff. I understand that. But when it comes to fans, super fans to be specific, I'm not a super fan, but I will tell you this. I think somehow it makes sense to me, like to see Abo Bota, Abo Mam Joy all over the state. The stadium, it just makes a lot of sense to me. There is something about it, man. I cannot put my words together and say it and construct a sentence, but there's something about it. Yes. You know, in life, there are people that get benefits just because of how far they have climbed the ladder. And we can't run away from that. So it's the same with those ones. But I will be having a problem if they are gatekeeping the industry in that whenever people are rising into prominency, then like what was happening, we were told that there are people now, when you arrive early at the stadium, right, even if you bought the ticket and it allows you to sit behind the bench, especially the games of Kaizer Chiefs, they will come, it's a group of people, they will come and sit behind the bench and they will kick you out. That now trying to monopolize it. And it has been said that they are now working with the camera crew. It is their responsibility to be picked because those ones are forcing themselves to rise into prominence. Maybe the target was this super fans funding. I don't know. Such can be condemned and we do not agree with it. So in a way, I agree with him, but somehow I don't agree with him in a sense that there is good that comes with us having these people all over the stadium. It motivates us in a way to go to the stadiums. So when you stop the funding, you be careful of not crippling football in South Africa so far as the fans are concerned, because these people have been the motivation around that. So I think that is what I wanted to cover. So far as the Minister of Sports, Arts and Culture, Gayton McKenzie, that whatever move you take here, you really have to be careful because you don't want to get into a situation where you stop a moving vehicle by you know what I'm saying? You stop something good that was happening because when you are saying that people are benefiting unduly. But you don't. That is my concern, and I raised that even yesterday to say the video that I did yesterday to say some people, right? Look, some of the things we should not measure it by who is doing it, but we should measure it by their impact as well, right? We can't just say, oh, we know you've been benefiting there, but Uporta has got a name as a supporter in general in South Africa. He's got a name, Mam Joy. They've got a name as a supporter, right? Abo Machaka, they had a name. Today, Abo Machaka, they are part and parcel of Abo Tore Funeral, if I'm not mistaken. They are part and parcel of Abo Itiski TV, Nabonkululego. Because they build a name around the super fans, Abo Joaha, you know what I'm saying? Abo, there are some of you Orlando Pirates fans that I've forgotten about them. I'm saying we expect them, it's an expectation. Every game, we expect them, we want them to be there. It's like, it's an uncommunicated thing, and others are building their thing. It's okay. Like, it's okay. We don't have a problem with it in a sense that when it is done correctly. So I'm saying there's nothing necessarily wrong with us having them as our public figures motivating us to go to the stadiums. So cutting the fans when there is something right about it, that's where I differ with Gayton McKenzie.